Look at them, Gwen. It's obvious Teresa's had a boyfriend all along, just like she said.
It's all just a little too convenient for me, Ethan. I'm not sure I believe that this guy's really Teresa's boyfriend.
But he said he was. And he even explained why we never met him before tonight. And what more proof do you need?
I don't know, but I intend to get it.
Oh, Gwen, look, I feel bad enough already about accusing Teresa of lying about her boyfriend.
And you seem much more concerned about Teresa's feelings than you do about getting to the truth.
We've gotten to the truth. Teresa has a boyfriend. His name is Chuck. I mean, they're obviously crazy about each other. What more do you want?
I don't know. Look, I'm sorry, Ethan, but something just doesn't sit right with me about all this. Did you see the look on Teresa's face when Chuck first walked up to the table? She was just as stunned as we were to see him standing there.
Well, maybe she had given up on him showing up at all. I mean, he said he had car trouble before.
Or maybe she was shocked speechless because she's never seen him before in her life. Wait, Ethan, please, just bear with me, just for a minute. So, why don't we all sit down?
Oh, I wish we could, but Chuck's got to make it an early night, so we better get going.
Oh, well, I'm sure you don't have to leave just this second.
Gwen.
I mean, there are so many things I'd love to know about you. Like, where'd you two meet?
Lighthouse Park.
So Teresa says school and you say the park. Which is it, Chuck?
Both.
Tell Teresa something.
Oh, but...
We'll be right back. I wanted to say thank you.
For what?
Well, for getting Chuck to show up so Gwen could meet him.
Oh, I'm just glad he could make it.
I'm not surprised. I'm sure you're pretty tired of Gwen accusing you of not having a boyfriend.
It hasn't been much fun for any of us.
No, but thanks to you, it's almost over. I mean, now that Gwen's finally seen your boyfriend with her own eyes, she'll accept my marriage proposal.
Oh, Ethan. You don't have to thank me for that.
No, why not? I mean, if it weren't for you, who knows what my future might be?
I just don't believe any of us control our destinies. It's all in the hands of fate.
Hey, Ethan, listen to this. I mean, Chuck's been dating Teresa for a while now, and he doesn't even know the name of her older brother. I find that rather odd, don't you? How could you possibly be Teresa's boyfriend and not know the name of her older brother?
Well, you see, the reason Chuck doesn't know my brother's name is because Luis is very strict with me. He would go crazy if he found out I was dating anyone seriously. So I've never introduced them.
You know that's true, Gwen. I mean, that's why Teresa's never told her brother that she works for my mother.
And I would appreciate if you wouldn't blow the whistle on me and tell him yourself.
You have our word.
Thank you, Ethan. Yeah, if that's all, Gwen.
I could swear I know you from somewhere.
I don't think so. I'd remember.
Maybe it was on television. You wouldn't happen to be an actor, would you?
Hardly.
Then what do you do for a living? Unless Teresa pays you to pose as her boyfriend.
That's a good one. As if Teresa would have to pay any guy to go out with her.
Well, of course it was a joke.
Not a really funny one either, Gwen.
The truth is, I don't have a paying job. I've been very fortunate in that my family's done quite well.
Don't tell me you live off a substantial trust fund.
Actually, I do. My great-grandfather invented the paperclip.
Ah! Oh, I don't think so. It just so happens that my great-grandfather was very close friends with the inventor. I used to hear stories about him when I was growing up. His name is Charles Wilson.
Yes, I'm named for him. They call me Chuck for short.
Oh my goodness. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I hope I haven't offended you.
Not at all. Well, I really do have to go. Coming, Angel?
Actually, I changed my mind. Whitney's still here, so I think I'll stick around for a while.
You sure?
Yes, sweetheart.
Well, Gwen and I are heading out ourselves. It was nice meeting you, Chuck.
Pleasure's all mine. Mm-hmm. Good night, Gwen.
Night, Chuck.
Good night.
You satisfied?
I can't believe I was wrong. Teresa's not in love with you. I twisted everything around and acted like a miserable, possessive shrew. Ethan, can you ever forgive me?
I just want you to remember that you never had anything to be afraid of. You know, I'll never love anyone but you.